Hey Al, finally, we thought that Line 6 has forgotten about us Line 6 PodGo and Line 6 PodGo wireless users, but they haven't, and the firmware update, the 1.30 update, is finally here. So October 5th is the day that we have all been waiting for. I usually improvise through my videos with the stuff I'm gonna say and always with the stuff I'm gonna play, and this one's gonna be no exception, but honestly, I'm not prepared as I was for any of the previous videos because this is just out and I'm gonna explore it together with you. Now, before I start exploring the new amps and the new effects that came in the 1.30 update, I want to inform you of one very important thing, and that is the way that you're gonna update your PodGo. First, you gotta update the software, and then you gotta update the firmware. The software is this. PodGo Edit is a software, and the firmware is the thing that's going inside your unit that's going to bring all the new amps and the effects. Also, there's another instruction that Line 6 gave us, and I haven't seen this one before, and I'm gonna read it to you. Is there anything else I should know about this update? And they say yes. We strongly recommend performing a factory reset after updating your PodGo firmware to 1.30 and then restoring your backup. So, if you're gonna do the update, first, backup everything you got. So the way you create a backup is this. You go to File, Create Backup, and then you just press Create Backup, and it's gonna create a backup. It's gonna export to your global settings, your impulse responses, and this is new user model defaults. That's a new option for sure. And of course, it's gonna save all your presets. Now you may be wondering two things. One, there's a giant thunderstorm outside and the rain is just pouring. And the second thing is, how do you do a factory reset? And it's quite simple. After you unplug your pod, after you've done the backup and the update of the PodGo Edit and the PodGo firmware, you will turn on the pod, but you will hold down the C and the D foot switches at the same time, and don't release them because you will see a little messages display on top of your screen that will say erasing that, resetting that, and it's a factory reset. So I repeat one more time, to perform a factory reset, hold down the C and the D switches at the same time and then turn on your pod, but don't release the C and the D switches until the operation is complete. Now, the first thing in this update that's probably gonna get the most attention is the Mandarin Rocker, which is based on the Orange Rockerverb 100 Mark III, the dirty channel. There are also a few new effects. One is the Ratatouille distortion, which is a Proco Rat model, but I know that Line 6 wasn't happy with their previous model of the Proco Rat, and Ratatouille distortion is the one that's supposed to be better. The next thing is the Euclidean delay, and this is another Line 6 original delay, and I'm gonna check that later and won't read all these things right here. Now, the thing that I'm really excited about is the dynamic hall and the hot springs, which are the two new reverbs that we received in this update. Dynamic hall is a hall type of reverb, I would guess. And there are plenty of tweaking parameters. And I am extremely happy to see that we have both diffusion and damping inside a reverb plugin, which is kind of essential. In the other reverb, the hot springs, we can of course guess that it's a spring type of reverb. And from what I heard in the demos a couple of months back, when that particular reverb came out for the Helix, is that it actually drips. The 63 spring reverb that we had so far and the spring reverb that we had so far definitely did not drip. And spring reverbs need to drip. Now, this next feature is amazing. You can set your own user model defaults. So once you dial in your favorite amp setting or your favorite reverb setting or your favorite delay setting, you can save that block's state as a default. And that means that you won't have to go through the process of setting up and dialing in that particular block again. This is really amazing. The other great thing, and I know many people have been requesting this, is the ability to change the name of the snapshot so it doesn't say just snapshot one with inside that little, I don't know what's that, a photo camera or what. so the ability to name snapshots and assign a specific color to them is great. One important setting that was changed is inside the global settings, inside the ins and out sections, and it's specifically about the volume knob that you have on the PodGo. Before this update, the volume knob controlled only the main out. And now, as you can see, as they said, we can control the main out, the amp out, or both. Okay, enough with the boring stuff. Let's actually see the new amp and the new effects. The first thing that I'm gonna search for is, of course, the Mandarin Rocker, which is this one right here. Okay, so the new amp Mandarin Rocker, I'm gonna pair it up with the Mandarin cabinet as well. And let's find the Hot Springs Reverb. Where are you at? Oh, there's the Hot Springs Reverb. I'm gonna put that. I'm gonna try to load up the Euclidean delay as well. I'm gonna load the Euclidean delay before the reverb. The new amp, the Mandarin Rocker, the new Euclidean delay, and the new Hot Springs Reverb is kinda maxing out our DSP now. As you can see, if I try to add a distortion unit, there's only one that I can add, and that's the megaphone, and I don't wanna get into that, honestly. But let's try to hear the Mandarin Rocker on its own with some amounts of reverb. Okay, so I have no idea how this will sound. We have the Mandarin Rocker, the delay is off, but I left the Hot Springs reverb on. Okay, so let's try to dial in a bit cleaner sound, and I'm gonna manipulate these values of the Hot Spring Reverb. Let's increase the spring count number. Honestly, I'm really happy to hear this, and I'm actually pleased. I've spent literally just 1 minute. What? It drips on its own. Anyway, I'm really happy with the sound of this Hot Springs Reverb because it delivers what spring reverbs usually deliver, and that's that drippy feel that you get when you try to play a short note. Listen to this drip. Let's try to increase the dwell as well. Now I'm gonna bring in the Euclidean delay without actually changing any of the settings. So we have feedback, steps, fill, rotation. What the hell is a rotation in a delay? I have no idea. We have the low cut, the high cut. We have the trails, the usual things we have inside the delay. But honestly, let's try to increase the delay time a bit. Let's put it at 420 milliseconds. What else number could it be? Thank you. We'll try to increase the feedback drastically. So to me, this sounds like a really advanced multi-tap type of delay, and I need to familiarize myself with the settings so I can try demo the settings. But from what I hear, it's gonna be great for ambient tones for sure. Finally, I'm gonna test one more thing, and that is the new dynamic hall. I'm gonna bring out this reverb because I can't control it yet. This sounds really good. Let me increase the decay. Let me lower down this pre-delay, that's way too much. Let's bring down the damping just a bit. And let's increase the mix. And let's increase the motion as well. I'm gonna increase the room size now. Ooh, that's a nasty transition. I'm gonna increase the mix. And that's all I'm gonna do. I'm gonna increase the low cut as well. Ooh. So we have 20.2 seconds of decay in a room size that's 30 meters. What, that's square meters, I guess? I'm not sure. So that's way too much diffusion. Let's bring it back a bit. Let's try a smaller room size. I actually don't like the sound. I'm gonna bring it back to 20, lower the decay, and where's the mix knob? Where's the mix knob? There you are. Let's bring in that weird Euclidean delay. You know what? In the middle of this, I'm gonna change the mic to a 57. I'm gonna bring down the distance because this lacks bass. So this is gonna be days of fun for me. Let's see how much delay can we actually get. We can get, what, infinity? Let's try infinity. this delay is sounding really weird, but this infinity is sounding really good. Anyway, off with the delay, back with the room reverb, and let's see how crunchy can this thing get. So one thing that we obviously need here is a gate. Well, I'm gonna bring down the decay time. Man, minus 52 sounds reasonable. Anyway, I want to check one more thing. I'm gonna make some random changes to this sound so it's not like it was before. And I'm gonna change this to user default. And when I click user default, so let's try to open up a new preset and let's try to load the Mandarin Rocker again. And as you can see, our presets are there, and this is honestly for me, except for the ability to rename snapshots, the best thing we got to save the default state of the block we want.